we're going to do is hammer the old chest day. I call this day chesticles for the spectacles. I just made that up. Pretty clever. Well, sorry. I do always want to make sure first exercise needs to go at about 25% pace, okay? I want speed one, always. This always will tell you, do I have any pulled muscles? Am I going to get a headache because I'm not breathing out and going too hard? Chin-ups, push-ups, anything super hard right away will give you a headache, okay? If you're finding yourself getting headaches, it's that reason, or you need to get a carb. You can always have emergency carbs, which are rice cakes, which again we'll get into. But the very first workout, we're gonna start where dead even. I want your hands facing in so that we're using our armpits to press. Too many of y'all push backwards like this, hence using your shoulders, okay? I want you to get in there and stretch your armpits. So as I go down, suck in, blow. Core to go with you, I want a little bit of feet spread. Come down, big flex in the inside of the arms, big blow, big flex. Suck in, feel every muscle go. So you're gonna superset that with my famous meet in the middle at the start. If it hurts your lower back, bend your knees for this one. If you can do this one, okay, make sure you're doing it slow. This is great for the abs. We're gonna do a lot of ab workout. Okay, suck in, one, stretch, breathe out on the top, suck in, and blow. Okay, once you do your set to 15 from there, then you're going to go into the full crunch. Whenever I do abs, this is my pace. Reason why it saves your neck, okay? And I can focus on squeezing the abs. It's about breaking the muscle. It doesn't matter how many times you do it. How many reps, okay? How many reps does it take, Tyler? As many as it takes. How many am I supposed to do? As many until you can't do it yourself. So let's go hard, okay? Let's go smart, especially at the start, first week. Make sure you're not focused on just fucking killing it so bad you hurt yourself. Quality versus quantity. Baby steps up, and then we'll crunch you down once you've got that form dead on. I want perfect smooth motion. That's what is quality. As I come in, flexing my abs, suck in. Three sets of these bad boys. Warm up complete. You're gonna be feeling pretty good. What we're gonna do is the incline chest press. One of my favorite exercises because dumbbells are great for stability. Don't need a lot of weight here. I just want you to, again, focus on the form. So as we kick up, okay, watch how I put the weight on my knees. As I go, I'm going to use as much leg as possible. Reason being, I'm going to need that arm strength for the last rep or two. So as I kick up, kick, kick, fall back. If you notice, I started the incline on a higher incline, which is going to get a lot of shoulders. We're going to do Jacob's ladder, this is called. We're going to go down the level each time for the first one. Notice I'm facing in on my chest. I'm not pushing out too much where this will get the wide part of my chest, but also gets a lot of shoulders. Okay, depends what you're targeting. As I go back, lower back tight to the seat. One, big flex. This will get your chest muscles up closer towards your neck. Two, suck in. Big kiss, this is called a kiss at the top, making sure you're even sucking in. Big thing you want to make sure, don't stress your neck by holding it too much. I'm almost letting it flow down with very little resistance. Stretch. Head back. Tight core. Nice, smooth. Big breath there. That's your power, don't forget that. Okay, so I brought the seat a little lower for the second set. What we're going to do this time is no kiss. I'm going to go straight out like this. One. I'm going to go about 90% up. For women, I want you to go 100% up. For men, I want you to keep it here. This is going to work more of the chest. For the women, I want you to focus on more the bottom of the tricep, which is right over here. Okay? Stretch, keeping all the pressure in my armpit. As soon as I do this, I feel my shoulders doesn't feel nice. Still in my armpits, that pressure, kick out. Flex the inside of the arms, about 90% up. Okay, once you're done that set for the third set, you're gonna go more to the lower incline, and you're gonna focus on pushing the weights similar, but different grip. Okay, but don't let that fool you. Don't bring your elbows like this, because then you'll push with your shoulders. The way to do the side grip, same way. The same way as this, okay? The only difference is, you're keeping it in. One. This is a lot harder press. You'll find your weight will be a lot tougher. I'm flexing the inside of my arms, inside of my chest. As I get it off, I'm going to, if I was here, I would turn the weight. Come down, bring, gentle. We don't throw the weight. These are our tools. These are our shape muscles. We treat them with respect. Okay, so the steering wheel. I see you, and I see all you who think you're gonna cheat on my diet. I know, and I don't even need to be around, and I gotta call y'all out. So y'all committed to me, remember this. I don't fart around. If you cheat on my diet, I will fucking punish you hard. Okay? You cheat often, you're off the team. Okay? I'll give you your money back. I don't care. Don't waste my time. We're gonna get the best goddamn results. It's 42 fucking days. You can sacrifice it. And then you got all year to kind of sort your stuff out. Okay? We get it? Alright. I mean, gotta take my medication today. Steering wheel. You can use a lighter weight. Flex. Bottom of the chest. Top of the chest. Flex. Also a good one for the shoulder. Flex. 20 times until failure. Notice my back. I'm not slouching too much and I'm not leaning too far back. Okay? You want to stay pretty upright. If anything, you'll lean forward. Once you're there, done your 20, you're going to give me the crossovers. One. Squeeze that chest. Bottom of the chest. Top of the chest. Bottom of the chest. Okay, once we do two sets of these guys, you'll go back to another steering wheel. We're gonna raise these guys up a little higher. Get a little bit of a lean over. So, second set, more towards your nipples. First set, more towards belly button. Squeeze. And if you get really good, you can add a little variety. Be creative. Ready? Okay. So what we're gonna do is the barbell push, okay? As we go in, I want you to go flat bench, get a heavier weight, focus on the squeeze of the inside of the chest, inside of the arms, triceps, 4, 5, 6, and you're gonna go till failure. Again, try not to drop the elbows too much because then you'll start using shoulders. Keep it in the armpits, big stretch, flex. Once you're done that, you're going to superset a fly. When we fly, I want you to be flat, curl those wrists in. You'll notice I protect my shoulders by keeping that curl. Once I go here, it's in my shoulders. Once I'm here, it stays in my armpit, so it keeps safe. I don't want to play with the front of my shoulders. If you lose that ability to push, that eliminates 3 of your workouts. So, and I don't have time to make you a detailed worker. This is what you get. Just kidding, I always have time for everyone. So, stretch, blow. Suck in, stretch, blow. And then we're gonna finish off like that until failure. Okay, so. I love resistance bands. Again, what you have to realize throughout this program especially, we're gonna slow everything down, especially off the start. This is first off a great stretch. For those who have a lot of armpit fat, stretch that back. Anything that brings your shoulders back, look what it does to my arms. As you'll notice, the veins will start popping through. It's a good way to kind of get gripped with it. Not really doing much, but a little stretch, okay? So what I'm gonna do with these guys, is a push, lean down one foot, squeeze, a decline press, big flex with the arms, and then you're gonna superset that with a fly decline. Squeeze. Elbows up, keep it in the armpits, flex. And just kill that chest. Good? All right, so what we're gonna do here is a tricep extension. Just by doing, we can do this two ways. These are your single arm. One. For those, they're a little more difficult. I prefer one at a time to help. Just actually works a little bit better overall. But she gets tough. Keeping the elbow here, notice it's not falling. I'm just basically moving my wrist from here to here, full extension. Just like so. Then you're going to superset that with the two arm, more outside. This is a good one to tone the inside of the arms. Flex, flex, flex. It's all about toning, breaking those muscles. So when you repair them, if I repair them with a sloppy Joe, what do you think that's going to make? What kind of muscle? Squishy like Play-Doh probably. Hard piece lean a chicken, you replace your fat that you have because you worked out with that, and boom, we get results every freaking day! I don't care how much you improve. This person that worked the hardest last year got the best results. Effort equals results. Always, all the time. All I want you to do is get better every fucking day. Okay, so these can also be used as a core machine. I want to keep this as simple as possible so that people know that we barely touch machines, that you can do this workout at home with a Bosu ball, resistance band, small weights, chin up bar. It's not much. You can probably improvise and find stuff or anything like that around the house. So this band is a great way to tone the arms. We're going to do the bent. Backhanded, I want the elbows behind the body. That's going to help get further up the arm, the back of the arm where most girls hold their fat. Little kick outside. Okay, and then what we're gonna do is superset that with palm, straight arm, try, kick back. Getting the back of the arm, propping the chest, sit up straight, flex, hold those last ones, breath, woo! Let's go! Okay, the Bosu ball, one of your best friends here. So after your arms are already dead, this is going to be your finisher today. And I want you to keep track of this because we're going to have a little challenge at the end of this program and see who can do the most on video. Your goal is to not put the knee down at all. So your goal is going to be to do 15 per side. When you use your hand, I don't want you to push straight hand like this because it's hard on the wrist. Have that side grip and rate about 75% up on the Bosu ball. Whatever hand I go down with first becomes my press hand. So I'm gonna go down, down, rest, down, down, rest, down, down, rest. When I'm done that side, I've done 15, that's a no-no. Then I go to my right, down, down, rest. Whatever hand goes down first is your press hand. And these are exhausting, these are great for your abs. Make sure you relax your neck and always look down. Throughout this whole program, you have to remember not to tense up so much. When you're in your break, you're doing your stretches, the ones I taught you already, get good at that homework right away, okay? Legs tomorrow, it's not gonna be great.